Hello everyone, myself Dr. Ms. Tejasvi Shrirang Ghadge, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Humanities and Science, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. I welcome all of you in the session of physics. Today we will learn about polarization. In the previous session, we see the difference between polarized and unpolarized light. The terms plane of vibration and plane of polarization, difference between isotropic and anisotropic crystal, and structure of calcite crystal. Now, at the end of session, students will able to understand the concepts double refraction, ordinary ray and extraordinary ray, positive and negative crystal, and Malus law. These are the content of the session. Double refraction is also called as birefringence, an optical property in which a single ray of unpolarized light entering an anisotropic media is splits into two rays, each traveling in a different direction. One ray is bent or refracted at an angle as it travels through the medium, and other ray passes through the medium remains unchanged. Double refraction can be observed by comparing two materials, glass and calcite. If a pencil mark is drawn upon a sheet of paper and then covered by a piece of glass, only one image will be seen. But if the same paper is covered with a piece of calcite and the crystal is oriented in a specific direction, then two marks will be visible. Let us see in detail double refraction. In 1669, Erasmus Bartholinus discovered that when a beam of ordinary unpolarized light is passed through a calcite crystal, the refracted ray splits into two refracted rays as O ray and E ray. The O ray travels through the calcite crystal without deviation, while E ray refracted at some angle. Within the crystal, O ray always lies in the plane of incidence, whereas E ray does not lie in the plane of incidence in a principal section. The O ray and E ray are linearly polarized. The E ray has its vibrations parallel to the principal section, whereas the vibrations in O ray are perpendicular to the principal section. The O ray travels with the same velocity in all directions in a crystal, whereas E ray travels with different velocities in different directions. Hence, refractive index of O ray is constant and refractive index of E ray varies, and it is maximum or minimum value. The difference between refractive indices is known as the amount of double refraction or birefringence. Ordinary ray or O ray obeys the law of refraction, whereas E ray does not obey the laws of refraction. These two rays are plane polarized, but they are right angles to each other. The diagram shows O ray represented by dot component of, that is, the vibrations of O ray are perpendicular to optic axis. E ray represented by arrow component, which means vibrations are in a principal plane. The phase difference between E ray and O ray is 180 degree or pi radian. Hence, the phenomenon of splitting of unpolarized light into two polarized light rays, that is, extraordinary ray and ordinary ray, after passing through a certain crystal is known as double refraction. The crystal showing this phenomenon is known as doubly refracting crystal or birefringent. Calcite and the quartz, these are the examples for birefringent crystal. Think for a while. What is the phase difference between E ray and O ray? As shown in figure, the calcite rome having a double refracting phenomenon, when two rows of dots with each row corresponding to one of the two light rays, as the light ray splits when it is entered into the calcite, while on the paper it shows the single row of dot. Now, let us see the difference between ordinary and extraordinary ray. Ordinary ray has a vibrations perpendicular to principal section, while in E ray has a vibrations parallel to the principal section. The refractive index for O ray and E ray given by the formulas. O ray travels with the same speed in all directions, whereas E ray travels in different speeds in different directions. The refractive index same for all angles of incidence, whereas in E ray refractive index varies with angle of incidence. For ordinary ray, the velocity of light inside the crystal will be less than extraordinary ray. For extraordinary ray, the velocity of light inside the crystal will be more than O ray. Now, let us see the difference between positive and negative crystal. The E ray is totally contained within O ray, while in negative crystal, the O ray is totally contained within the E ray. The diagram shows the orientation of E ray and O ray and the changes in the refractive indices. In positive crystal, E ray travels slower than O ray except along the optic axis, while in negative crystal, O ray travels slower than E ray in all the directions except along the optic axis. The birefringence is positive and in negative crystal it is negative. For positive uniaxial crystal, quartz and ice are the examples, while for negative crystal, calcite and tourmaline are the examples. Now, let us see the Malus law. Statement of the law. The intensity of plane polarized light transmitted through the analyzer is proportional to the cosine square of angle between the plane of transmission of analyzer and plane of transmission of polarizer. Consider a figure in which the unpolarized light when passed through a polarizer, we are getting the plane polarized light, which is analyzed by an analyzer through some specific rotation theta, which is detected under detector. When unpolarized light is incident on the polarizer, the transmitted light is linearly polarized. If the light further passes through an analyzer, then intensity varies with angle between transmission axis of analyzer and polarizer. The three diagram shows the intensity variation with angle between polarizer and analyzer. With change in rotation of analyzer, the intensity changes from maximum to zero. Now, let us consider the intensity of unpolarized light be I naught, and hence the intensity of plane polarized light be I naught by 2. When plane polarized light is passed through an analyzer, then E be the amplitude of vibrations and theta be the angle between analyzer and polarizer. E can resolve in two components, E cos theta, which is parallel to the plane of analyzer, and E sin theta, which is perpendicular to the plane of analyzer. But only parallel components will be transmitted, and hence the intensity of corresponding component will be given as. This proves the Mahler statement. We state the intensity varies with angular rotation between analyzer and polarizer, that I is directly proportional to cos square theta. These are the references for the session. Thank you.